24 hours before we arrived south of Tuzhurma to ISIS had attacked, catching the Kurdish Peshmerga unit off guard. It won't happen again. Peshmerga Commander Colonel Hakim Karim Ahmed watched ISIS appear just an hour after the Iraqi army withdrew, casually staking their claim without firing a single shot. That used to be with the army. He points out a two-story building just a couple hundred meters away.
That's the ISIS flag right there. طيب داعش موجود هناك هلا.
Another planted on the water tower. The battle lines drawn, but for over a week not crossed. Then came the ISIS assault. They came at us from three directions, Colonel Ahmed tells us. The battle lasted for 6 hours. In the distance, an Iraqi military vehicle commandeered by ISIS.
The intersection that this combat outpost is protecting is incredibly strategic. Saddam Hussein's hometown of Tikrit in that direction. To the north, the oil-rich city of Kirkuk. Suleimaniyah in Iraqi Kurdistan to the east and then to the south. A two-hour drive, a straight shot to the capital.
There were gunmen with them, people from the area, Colonel Ahmed remembers. It was ISIS fighters and also people from the tribes. It's a murky, dangerous alliance, opening multiple fronts towards Baghdad and testing the Peshmerga's resolve in the north.
They had two casualties during the firefight, one of them happening right here. One of their commanders was killed, and he was just saying that this is some of the blood stains that are still here.
The Kurds, a population with a long and tormented history, vow they won't give up this land. As ISIS and Sunni fighters carve out their territory, the Kurds are making sure they stay out of theirs. Arwa Damon, CNN, Salahuddin Province, Iraq.